EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the world's steel capital in the city of bridges, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Acrisure Stadium. Today we hit double digits, week 10, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers. Shadows starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage, and now third and 11 coming up. Tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. On third down, Jackson. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going down. T.J. Watt able to record his fifth sack of the season. Facing fourth down, Baltimore will punt. Jordan Stout out there. Devin Tompkins deep to return it. Returnable here from the 38. 48-yard punt, 7 on the return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, 1st and 10. So good field position for the Steelers as they come up 1st and 10 at the 45. Harris starts the drive on the ground, and he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about 5.
Ball right on the 50-yard line. Here's a 2nd and 5.
Now here's another carry for Harris. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be 3rd down.
But you look at this defense.
They've certainly had their struggles against the run at the 30th ranked unit out of 32 teams in the NFL.
The numbers are definitely not in their favor, but every time I click on the film and watch them, I see stretches where they play against the run really well. Their biggest problem, when you give up those explosive runs, those 30, 40, 50-yard runs, that'll really mess up your averages.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down.
4th down, Corliss Waitman now on to punt.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complimentary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance if they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing. It puts them in that position. The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
On second down, Jackson. And looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. And he's going to get this on down to the 13-yard line. And this, Charles, definitely not what they were wanting to see. Remember, he threw three interceptions in the loss last week, and now he gives the ball away again here in the very first quarter.
And you have to think that this was drilled into him all week, too, by his teammates, by his coaching staff. They've told him all week long, we've got to protect the football. They probably crossed that fine line with giving him the right advice and saying it too much, and it turned out that it got into his head a little bit.
6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you keep.
He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Najee Harris. His 11th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Steelers take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Extra point put through by Boswell. And that makes the score 7-0. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They've shown very little offensively to this point. Well, neither team has, really. They come up here now, first down. Yeah, so they get that one, Charles, on the right tackle.
Yeah, oftentimes in that spot, you're trying to work against a defender, trying to set the edge in the running game, and you're trying to drive around and get your body twisted so that he can't get there. Sometimes your hands get too involved.
Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
And able to use his stiff arm for a little bit of leverage before he's taken down. A pretty good gain.
Ball at the 24 and a second and 11.
Now it's Jackson. And that's going to be incomplete.
You look at the Steeler defense.
Against the pass, they've had some issues, ranked number 23 in the NFL right now.
With the lack of pass defense, they do make up for in run defense, a top 10 unit against the people trying to move the ball on the ground. This is a passing league, so there's a conundrum for them. How do they get better defending the pass?
And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. Fourth down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt. It's a 40-yard punt, 6 yards on the return, and out will come the offense as they take over. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
Well, partner, fast forward with me for a second. Remember, next week they have the open week, so they're going to get some extended rest. Does that change how they manage the rest of this one?
I think it does a little bit, but not by too much, because you're right. You get the extra rest, you get a chance to heal up and kind of, you know, do a little bit of a reset for this team. But it's also 7 extra days to think back to the last time you were on the field. So now, a little more importance on what they're getting done because they carry it with them for essentially 2 weeks.
41 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
And they'll send Pickens in motion right here.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Good for 18. One thing's for sure, this defense has to figure out how to stop the ground game. He's eating him up here in the first quarter.
It looks like they have to go to different forces, aren't they? The conventional things aren't working too well. So I remember a coach of mine saying way back when a back's having a great game, you've got to get the ball out of his hands. See how far he can run without the ball. And what he meant was takeaways, knock it loose, because maybe you can't just stop him with just regular tackling.
In motion right is Smith. He'll get it here on the jet sweep. And he'll be taken down here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. From the 22 now, here's the second down and 6. Harris running straight ahead. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 13-yard line. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Now Pickett looking to change things up. Now a play fake here on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and 1 yard. They'll try the right side with Harris. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ballgame as they come up 1st and 10. Up to the 20. 2nd and 7 from the 20. To throw is Jackson. And this one incomplete. Too much contact behind that one, and it's 3rd down. They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Jackson. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Excellent play there on 3rd down. Give him 25 yards.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Running lanes non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Here's McGee. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5. Play action. Now Jackson. Pass on the crossing route is complete. This is Andrews. And they're going to have themselves another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 25-yard line. On the carry, McGee.
They'll get this down to the 21, just on the edge of the red zone. from the 21. Here's second and six.
Now Jackson. Touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Ravens have got it back to within a score. Justin Tucker for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14.
At their own 14-yard line.
What are you doing?
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And they have the game here followed by the open date on their calendar next weekend. And Charles, this is a crew that you have to think really is relishing the opportunity to be on the couch for a few days.
Yeah, they certainly are, but let's face it, partner. They can't get caught looking ahead to that couch time while they're playing this one. They've got to take care of business first.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. It's rare that a man his size can't at least push forward for a yard, but they stopped him there for nothing.
You're talking about Tiny? You're talking about the little guy back
Tiny.
There? That monster. Yeah, you're exactly right. And it takes a group effort to get a guy like that down and not let him find some space. The first guy in, he's got to take one for the team, right? Because he's just waiting there and holding on for everyone else to help him out.
It's a gain of 22 as we tick towards the 2-minute warning.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Off the play fake, here's Pickett. Flush to his right. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
You know what I like about that play? He didn't try to do too much on first down. He took what the defense gave him, put together a solid gain to bring up 2nd and manageable. Now they have a couple of plays to pick up just a few yards and a new set of downs.
Trying to keep those big legs churning, but he's going to go down in the backfield. Now Pickett.
The stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
Here's Corliss Waitman now. And this will pin him back deep. That's going to kick out of bounds right at about the 7-yard line. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
Jackson on first down. That one into the hands of Flowers. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. This is McGee. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Now it's Jackson. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. The Ravens going to use the 2nd of their timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. Here's Jackson to throw. That is incomplete.
That's some good closing speed there defensively because that looked open for a minute. That's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up. Converged on his man and broke the play up.
An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. Throwing is Jackson. Dancing to his left. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
Well, here's your first example of how this guy can beat you in more ways than one, because they took away his arm, but he was more than happy to dissect it with his legs for that first down pickup.
A couple of first downs on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Jackson now. From the out route, incomplete. It's Flowers. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 11 more on that one and another first down.
And maybe that touchdown on the previous drive has re-energized this offense a little bit. They've been kind of sluggish until then, but they're showing signs of life here, and they get good yardage that time and a first down.
Open man downfield is Duvernay. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. 23 yards, the final tally. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. Tucker's kick is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one-possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they'll have time for one play. That's it. 3 seconds to go before intermission. And they work this well upfield across the 45. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. So time for the second half as the Steelers have the lead, and they will also be receiving the football here to start the third quarter. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And not a good return here at all, as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they've got the lead now, a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too.
So it looks like somebody may have forgotten the snap count, and a 5-yard penalty ensues. A bad false start penalty there. Now second and six. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And this is going to be a Steelers first down as they take this up to about the 33-yard line.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
picture of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Now Pickett will look to pass him. Oh, tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Marcus Williams. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. After the interception, here's Jackson. He finds his man. And he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And his crew will take over with the football at the 35-yard line. And they had just picked it off to get the football. They fumble it right back. I looked over to both sidelines. A lot of scrambling to find the helmets.
Yeah, you can almost, I mean, you know both sides are screaming sudden change. Because when sudden change happens, that's a defensive call to get back out on the field. There's been a fumble, so an interception, some type of a turnover. You've got to get back out there and play. These guys just want to get to the bench and gather themselves and regroup a little bit. Let's see if these offenses can settle in and start taking care of ball a little bit better.
Now here's a throw that's complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football up and catch him off balance.
And he did. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Yo, why the fuck is a lineman lining up as a cornerback for me? Come on, bro. Look at this corner to the right. Come on, yo.
First down, and they go back to Harris.
What the fuck is... Can you pause the game? I can't pause it. It's not letting me pause. This nigga on some shit, and I know you hear me, bro. It's a bitch ass nigga, y'all. Hope you hear that too. Can't fucking pause the game. You see what the fuck I was saying, man.
Well, for the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. Right now, they're in a bit of a tough spot here, CD. You're trailing by double digits. Remember the last time out, they fumbled. They're going to have to play some clean football here on this possession.
And all the talk on their sideline has been about taking care of the football, making sure that they're handling the ball correctly. So you know they'll be squeezing the rock pretty tight here. They just have to be careful not to go so hard at doing that that they actually cause themselves other problems. Take care of the ball, but still try and play free and natural.
Jackson's thrown into the hands of Andrews. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
They'll run with McGee.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Jackson. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Now a handoff up the middle. McGee. And he is going to lose yardage here. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
A loss of two.
Play action. It's Jackson. And this is in the hands of Andrews downfield. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And that's going to leave them with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt them. We'll be back. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. He'll try to run this one in. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the line. Jackson. This is caught. So he'll be stopped here for no gain. And that will lead to a third and goal.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them.
And again, touchdown, Baltimore. The sneak successful from a yard out. And the Ravens are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. Jackson and the Ravens still on the field. They'll go for two. Toss coming right side. McGee, and he will get into the end zone to cut the lead down to a single point. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And he'll elect not to run with it. A fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. Pickett leads the Steelers up here with a fresh set of downs at their 25-yard line. Harris will start the drive out. There's a nice move, and he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. 158 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. Harris going to get it again on second down. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he will have a first down as they get into the ground at the 37.
Of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. On second down, this is Harris. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That burst good for 20 on first down.
We're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
And he's tapping a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Is Harris. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. That's good for 21 yards on a first down.
As I take a look at the clock, I realize that this drive is eating up a good portion of the fourth quarter already. Gotta tell you, partner, when you're trying to salt away a game, this is exactly what it's supposed to look like.
And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Steelers will add to their fourth quarter lead. Extra point put through by Boswell. And as guys will take a 10-point lead. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This taken in at the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Well, that last touchdown we just saw, what an important one. Now it's back to a 2-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here, and they are in desperate need of finding the end zone. They go play action with Jackson. They're looking deep here for Flowers. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. It's a big play there for Baltimore. 48 yards.
And here's a spot where this offense says, we got to start making something happen. We're down 2 scores. It's the fourth quarter. We've got to start moving with some urgency. And here's a big play that gives them a ray of hope that they can get back in this one.
And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up. Back to throw. Jackson. He finds his man complete. It's Reed. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down. Looking to throw. Jackson throwing the out route incomplete. It's Reed. Touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Ravens have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And not a good return at all. Down inside the 10, all the way back at the 7.
Anytime you feel the kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
Just because you've got the lead in the fourth, it doesn't mean you have to play it safe. I like the aggressive play call there to push it downfield. That time, it didn't work out.
Here's second and 10. Pickett. And this one's incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Another incompletion would certainly be ideal defensively. A big play now. This is third and 10. Pickett now from the gun here. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up four.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
A 40-yard punt, no return, and the Ravens, they'll take over. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. They'll try and start this drive in the air. To the right side, into the hands of Flowers. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
40 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Second down and 4. To throw is Jackson. That'll be caught by the big tight end, Andrews. Apparently some grabbing there in the middle of the O-line.
I've often wondered why that doesn't happen more often for guys that play center. Having to snap the ball and then trying to get your hands into a proper position, that's difficult to do. He got caught that time.
On second down, Jackson. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line.
Well, it certainly appears to me that the defensive guys are starting to look a little bit tired. While he still has some fresh legs. Not the biggest game we've seen on a scramble, but still, some positive yardage on a play that initially looked like a sure win for the defense.
Well, this crowd is making an impact right now. Third and 10. Now it's Jackson. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's going to get out of bounds with the first down. So an ideal set of circumstances there. They move the chains, and they save that final timeout. McGee, what a great effort there. He's going to get this inside the 15, and they'll spot it at the 13-yard line. Nice run. And now all of a sudden, the shoe's kind of on the other foot. Maybe you pull the reins back here a bit?
Yeah, a little bit, because you got to make sure that you don't score too quickly.
Again, they'll run. This is McGee. A tough run gets him just inside the 10 to the 9, but no further. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Touchdown pass, and the Ravens have taken a fourth quarter lead. Tucker now for the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game.
Makes the score Ravens 32, Steelers 28.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. They'll come up first and 10 here. A handoff to Harris to begin the drive. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. So the road a little tougher here. Now first and 20. They hand this off to Harris. And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. They'll come up now on second down.
Brings up second down.
On the give, this is Harris. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Well executed there on second down, so do you go back to the air on third?
Well, that's a possibility, but now you've opened up things to where you showed that you would run the ball in long-distance situation. You might come back again because I doubt they believe you'll do it a second time.
On third down, here's Harris, and he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. Now the Steelers hustling up to the line of scrimmage. Now Pickett. Incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the two-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
This definitely four down territory at this point, but a critical third down here. Here's Pickett. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. This defense looking impenetrable now. Three straight incompletions. You're giving them nowhere to go with the football. Maybe a little frustrated back there.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. When you've missed on three straight, there's going to be some frustration. But now he's got to make sure that frustration is temporary, not lingering. Big throw coming up.
No choice but to go. Here's fourth down now. And whistles, and they take their final timeout with 7 seconds left. Fourth down, 10 yards to go. Pickett, fourth down, desperation time. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. It was a long shot, but they did get one final chance to try to score and overcome this small deficit. No touchdown there, Charles. And that brings this one to a close.
Yeah, I think hope was wearing one jersey and worry was wearing another on the other sideline as that final snap played out. Now, we've seen some incredible plays to win games before, but in this case, I think the distance is just a little bit too great for it to happen here.
So for Baltimore, it's a win they needed, if for nothing else in their sanity, as they move to 4-6. And they'll get another road date next week. Meanwhile, for the Steelers, it's a bit of a setback as they drop to 6-4 now. And they'll get a late bye next week, which might be coming at the right time. And they'll be back in action in week 12. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.